Hey, SEC family. Thanks for joining me today for another devotion. Today, I'd like to talk about how to prepare for eternity. One of the things we talk about all the time here at SEC is that this life is the dress rehearsal for eternity. We need to use this life to prepare for all the rest of eternity. But how? How do you do that? Here are four ways to live a life that matters in light of eternity. Number one, I get to know God. Establish your relationship with God. That's the first step. How? Well, the same way you do with anybody else. To have a relationship, it involves knowing the person, trusting the person, sharing with the person, enjoying the person, listening and spending time with that person. Communicate. You establish a relationship with God the exact same way. Spending time with Him, talking with Him, listening to Him through His Word. Second thing, I become more like Christ. That's the next thing, becoming like Jesus Christ. The Bible teaches that life is a school of character development. God wants us to use everything that happens in our life to build our character in us for eternity. Honesty, integrity, thankfulness, love, joy, peace, patience, goodness, gentleness, faith, meekness, self-control. God wants to build character in our life. He wants to make us like Jesus Christ, to have the character of Jesus Christ, who was a perfect example. If we want to know what God wants us to be like, just look at Jesus. This has been God's goal from the very beginning. All the way back in Genesis 1:26, it says, "Then God said, let us make human beings in our image." In our likeness. From the very beginning of time, it's been God's plan to make people like Himself. Not little gods, but godly and having the characteristics of God. From the very beginning of time, God has wanted to make men and women in His own image. You may say, well, doesn't God want me to be happy here and now? Of course He wants you to be happy here and now, but not at the expense of preparing us for eternity. God is far more interested in our character than He is in our convenience and comfort. Because this is just the first inch of life. The character we build now, we will enjoy for the rest of eternity. Third thing, I practice serving. We can prepare for eternity by practicing serving. God has some plans for us in eternity. He has plans for us to serve. He has a place for us to serve. We are going to be working in eternity, and we'll enjoy it. It will be perfectly suited to us. We will find fulfillment and meaning in it. God says you're going to serve in eternity. He wants you to practice serving while you're here for 60 or 70 or 80 years. This is the trial run, the dress rehearsal. Ephesians 2, verse 10 says, "We are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do the good things He planned for us long ago." God has given you talents and abilities, and He wants you to develop them. Meaning in life comes from serving. Jesus says, if you try to save your life, you'll lose it. But if you give your life away, you'll find it. The person who holds on to his life, who tries to just live for himself, is the person who is unsatisfied, unfulfilled, finds no meaning in life, is bored, and doesn't find true existence. But the person who gives his or her life away, who's willing to give up their life here and now for eternal rewards in the meantime, that person gets to enjoy their life here. Fourth thing, I have to share life's purpose with others. 2 Corinthians 5, 18 and 19, the Message paraphrase says, God put the world square with himself through the Messiah, giving the world a fresh start by offering forgiveness of sins. God has given us the task of telling everyone what he is doing. We are Christ's representatives. God uses us to persuade men and women to drop their differences and enter into God's work of making things right between them. Why does God leave us here on this earth after we become a believer anyway? He wants us to share the good news, to invest in people. People were made to last for eternity. If you want your life to count, spend your life telling people the good news and serving others. At Seminole Church, we are committed to helping you prepare for eternity. So when you get to the final exam, you'll know the right answers, because there will be a final exam. The greatest waste is to live our entire life without ever knowing the point of it. The best use of our life is to invest it in something that outlasts it. Hey, as your pastor, I'm going to be praying for you this week. I hope you have a fantastic day today and a great rest of your week. God bless.